to be exact, 3 a.m. to be exact, in the U.S. and other places will be midnight. And so it is a very strategic time for you to join us in a prayer mood. And as we've designated, as the Lord has led us, this year is our year of prayer. Amen. And so we want to be very prayerful this year, because I said in 31st night, during 31st night, that those who survive this year will be men and women of prayer. And so I want us to pray. Father, in the precious name of our Lord King and Master, we thank you for the privilege to come once again and to share and to be a blessing to your people. We've started another week, and we ask that you guide us in this week. You order our steps in this week. Let your purposes concerning this week be established. Amen. That at the end of the day, we'll be careful to say, Lord, we thank you. In Jesus' name, we call it done. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. So, I want to thank Pastor Esther, Pastor Fori, for being in the studio all the time to help regulate the prayer rain. Now, turn your Bibles with me to Leviticus 26, verse 14 to 39. We are talking about the mystery of covenant and curses. You can get it from one of my books. That's what we're going to be talking about throughout this week. And we're going to be standing upon that to pray. The mystery of covenant and curses and ordinances. We're going to be breaking ordinances, dealing with covenants and also curses. So let's take your Bibles to Leviticus 26, verse 14 to 39. The Bible says that if you will not listen to me, I'm not the one saying it, it's the word of God speaking. If you will not listen to me, if you will spurn my statutes, if your soul abhors my rules, so that you will not do all my commandments, but break my commandments, then will I do this to you. I will visit you with panic, with wasting disease. I'm going to read that particular scripture again. The Bible is saying in Leviticus 26, verse 14 to 39. The Bible is saying that if you will not listen to me, if you will spurn my statutes, and if your soul abhors my rules, so that you will not do all my commandments, but break my commandments, then will I do this to you. When you break my commandment, then will I do this to you. I will visit you with panic, with wasting disease. Now, one of the things I want us to establish as I introduce this subject today, I'm just going to introduce it, just to give you an idea of what we're going to pray about the whole of this week. I'm just going to give you an idea of what we're going to be dealing with throughout this week. One of the things I want to establish or make you aware is that God's covenant with his people are conditional. Let me give you an example. Let me tell you, God does not just bless in a vacuum because you're a child of God. God doesn't just bless you because you look nice or you look beautiful or you sing songs of worship or praise. God doesn't just bless you because of that. God blesses you based on principle, and one of those principles is that you follow the conditions that God has given to us. So God blesses his people based on conditions, and those conditions means that you are supposed to follow the statutes of God and not break his covenant that he has established with you. And so if you even look at the Bible, we talk about the Old Testament, the New Testament. If when I was doing religious studies in school, I was taught that the Testament that we're talking about, the Old Testament, the Old and the New Testament, the actual word is old covenant and new covenant. And so you need to understand that God works with his people based on covenant. And so you are either breaking a covenant or you are upholding a covenant. Hallelujah. And so I want you to understand that there are consequences for breaking the covenant, and there are blessings also that you attract as a child of God when you uphold and you keep the covenant of God. When you keep the covenant of God, there is a blessing attached to it. There are consequences for keeping the covenant, and there are consequences also for breaking the covenant. And so, if you look at the scripture, you will realize that in the Mosaic law, most of this covenant were established and laid out in the Mosaic law. And so, if you look at scripture, you will see that with Abraham, with Isaac, with Jacob, with all the patriarchs in the Bible, God entered into covenant with each one of them. God entered into covenant with each one of them. And the covenant that God entered with them was the covenant of blessing, the covenant of fruitfulness of their womb, the covenant of safety from their enemies, and more. But there were conditions of the covenant. God told them if they would do A, B, C, D, if they walk in his statute, uphold his statute, and follow his rules, then the promises that he had given to them through covenant were going to be established. In Leviticus 26, verse 14, verse 1 to 13. So these blessings were anticipated in their lives whilst they were here. And so, child of God, what I want us to understand is that God is love. I am not debating that fact, that God is love. But despite God is love, God also wants us to strive to walk in obedience. God wants us to walk in obedience. The blessing of the Lord does not just come in a vacuum. If you are walking in disobedience, the blessing of the Lord will not come upon your life. If you're a child of God and you are watching us and you are walking in disobedience, the blessing of the Lord will not come upon you. If you are walking in repentance, you will attract the blessing of the Lord. So God is speaking to you this morning, and God is telling you and I to repent if we have broken the statutes of God. If you have broken the law of God, God expects you to repent so that you can keep his covenant. You see, one of the things about God is that God never breaks his covenant. It's we who break God's covenant. God never breaks his covenant so far as we are concerned. That's why the songwriter said he's a covenant-keeping God. There is no one like him. Most of the time, when God enters into covenant, when we enter into covenant with God, or God enters into covenant with us, it is us who break the covenant of God. And so, in the Mosaic law, you will realize that Abraham and co were blessed because they followed astutely the covenant of God. Now, when covenants are broken, there are consequences. Let me give you an example. The consequences of breaking a covenant is a curse, because the direct opposite of a blessing is a curse. So when you break the covenant of God, you attract a curse that comes upon you. And these curses that I'm talking about include sickness. It includes sickness. It includes disease. It includes infertility. It includes when they go to battle, they will lose their wars. So defeat in war. And so you will notice that in the scriptures, in the Old Testament, you will notice that anytime Israel broke a covenant, either they had an infectious disease that came upon the land, or there were infertility, the land was not productive. You will notice that when they go to war, they lost their battles in war because they had broken a law. They had broken a covenant that God had told them to be faithful. And so if you remain impenitent, as a child of God, listen to me, if you remain impertinent and you remain faithful and you walk in obedience with God, you will see the faithfulness of God's covenant that He has established with you. And so, many people are walking, even in this 21st century, many of you who are watching me, many people are walking under a curse. A curse is operating in their lives because they have broken the statutes of God. Today, many of us have broken the statute of God through lesbianism, gays, things that are curses that the Lord has told us not to do. But yet there are people who are lesbians, gays, and there are so many things that are coming up about LGBT rights, all sort of fetish sex, all sort of things are going on that people are doing. They don't know that the more these things are done in our world today, the more curses are going to come upon the land. And so we are talking about coronavirus. Nobody knows where it's coming from. We are talking about sicknesses that cannot be cured, and nobody knows where it is coming from. And we are forgetting that one of the reasons why the world is going through all these calamities and all these challenges of our world today is because we have broken the covenant of God. We have broken the covenant of God, and we have become disobedient to the statute of God. And we are doing anything anyhow. And we expect God to just sit aloof and watch us. Anytime Israel did not heed to the voice of God, there were consequences. Ladies and gentlemen, anytime Israel did not heed to the voice of God and they were disobedient, a sevenfold punishment came upon them. And so, child of God, listen to me. Do you prefer to be blessed than to be cursed? Because let me tell you, child of God, many of us in our world today have banished the word of God from our hearts, and many of us are walking in disobedience, total disobedience. And so many of us, instead of a blessing, have banished God's blessing upon our lives. And so a lot of people are suffering. There is so much wickedness in the world today. There's so much intolerance in the world today, suffering in the world today, because many of us have brought the wrath of God upon ourselves because we have broken the covenant of God. If you are watching me and the sound of my voice, I want to ask you a simple question. Are you attracting the blessing of the Lord, or you are attracting the curse? Many of us, our waywardness in life and our disobedience to the word of God in our lives has brought the wrath of God, of God's punishment upon us, because we are breaking God's covenant. We have forsook the ways of the Lord and we have chosen our own ways. And God is using this morning broadcast. God is using this morning broadcast to draw our attention, to tell us that no one will go unpunished when we break the covenant of God. I'm telling you, nobody's going to go unpunished when the covenant of the Lord is broken. If you break God's covenant, there are consequences for that. Now, this morning, we are going to try to understand what a covenant is. I just gave you a few introductions of what the consequences of breaking a covenant, the blessing that are attached to breaking a covenant, and all that. And so some of these things I'm talking about, you can find them in Isaiah 65 verse 17 to 25 is there. You can find it there. Isaiah 65 verse 17, for those of you who like to take copious notes. Revelation chapter 21 verse 1 to 4, because of time I may not be able to read all the scripture. Then also Deuteronomy 28 15 to 68, you will find the scriptures there. that support some, most of the things I'm talking about, that there are consequences for breaking God's covenant and breaking God's law. And the law I'm talking about is in the scriptures, is in the Bible. The Bible is the law. So when you break the covenant in the Bible, that's why the Bible, I said that when we talk about the Old Testament and the New Testament, what it actually means is new covenant and old covenant. You understand? So when you break the covenant, which is the word of the Lord, there are consequences for breaking the covenant. And sometimes, because many of us say, well, Yahweh is love, God is love, so people continue to behave, to misbehave. Because anytime you talk about the wrath of God, people say, ah, God is love, God will not kill his own. Let me tell you, God may be love, but there's more to God that you can know. God is also wrath. God's wrath can come upon you when you disobey him and you don't walk in his statutes. And so don't think that because God, the Bible says that he is slow to anger, because God is love, so I can do anything and get away with it. It doesn't work that way. You can read Exodus 34, verse 6. Exodus 34, verse 6, for those of you who are writing notes. And Numbers 14, verse 18. Numbers 14, verse 18. You can also read Jonah chapter 4, verse 2. Hallelujah. And Joel chapter 2, verse 13. And Matthew 25, 31 to 46. All the scriptures back what I'm trying to say. There are people who even say that because we live in the dispensation of grace, that because of grace we can you can live anyhow. No, grace does not permit you to live anyhow. Grace rather helps you not to live anyhow. Hallelujah. So we cannot say that because we live in the time of grace, so sin must abound. No, sin does not abound in grace. And so there are consequences for sin. There are consequences when you break the laws of God and you break the covenant of God. There are consequences. Let us not take God for granted and think that you can do anything and get away with it. It doesn't work that way, child of God. It doesn't work that way. Now, today I'm going to trust God to be able to give you some few understanding or revelation about what a covenant is. I've already given you some few introduction already, but I'm going to go a little deeper. Then we pray. I want us to look at a scripture in Psalm 89, verse 34. Psalm 89, verse 34. The Bible said, my covenant will I not break. My covenant will I not break. Psalm 89, verse 34. My covenant will I not break, nor alter the things that is gone out of my lips. This is God speaking. And God is saying that my covenant will I not break, nor alter the things that is gone out of my lips. And so when we talk about a covenant is established between two people. A covenant is a strong agreement between two parties. A covenant is a strong agreement between two parties. A covenant is a contract with its descendant. So covenant does not only affect you, the person entering into the covenant with God, it even transcends even to your generation. It transcends even to your children. That is why the Bible said, for God is not mocked. Whatsoever a man soweth, he will reap. And so, when you enter into covenant with God and you keep the statutes of God, your children even benefit from that covenant. And so, in Genesis chapter 12, Abraham entered into covenant with God, and even his children benefited from the covenant that he had entered with God. In Genesis chapter 12. Because God is not a man to lie. Neither is he the son of man to repent. When God enters into covenant with us, he keeps the back end of his covenant. God always keeps his side of the covenant. The problem is us. We are not able to keep the covenant that God enters with us. And so God enters into covenant with Abraham and his descendant in Genesis chapter 12, where God says that in blessing I will bless you. He said to Abraham, that those who curse you, I will curse them. And those who bless you, I will bless you. Now, child of God, when Jesus died on the cross for you and I entered into a spiritual covenant with God when Jesus died on the cross. And so, there is a spiritual covenant between you and I. There's a spiritual covenant between you and God because you are a follower of Christ. Anybody who gives his life to Christ and allows Jesus to come and dwell in his heart, he becomes a follower of Jesus, a disciple of Jesus. When you become a disciple of Jesus, automatically you enter into a spiritual covenant with God. That is why the day you lifted up your two hands and you said, Jesus, I invite you into my life to be my Lord and personal Savior. That day you entered into a spiritual covenant with God. That is why your life cannot be the same. You cannot be in the old nature and still be a follower of Jesus. The day you surrendered your life to Jesus, what you were saying is that that extra luggage, that habit, that character, you are no longer part of it because you have entered into a covenant of obedience to obey the statutes of God, to obey the law of God, to obey the instructions of God. That is why you cannot be a child of God and still lead your life anyhow. You can't be a child of God and still fornicate. You can't be a child of God and still be lying. You can't be a child of God and still be gossiping. You can't be a child of God and still be living a wayward life. You can't be a child of God and still have envy in you. You can't be a child of God and still have gossip in you and still be stealing and lying. You can't be a child of God and still be living any kind of life, because the day you gave your life to Jesus, you became a follower of Jesus. And when you become a follower of Jesus, you enter into a spiritual covenant with Jesus.
Amen.
And so you cannot live your life anyhow. That is why when we obey, blessings become automatic. When we obey Him and we walk in His statute, the blessing of the Lord becomes automatic. And so, child of God, I want you to understand something. I'm going to read a scripture in Hebrews chapter 8, 6 to 7. Hebrews 8, 6 to 7. Hebrews 8, 6 to 7. But now have he obtained a more excellent spirit. But now have we obtained a more excellent ministry, excellent ministry. By how much as also he is a mediator, that is Jesus, of a better covenant, which was established upon a better promise. For if that first covenant had been faultless, then should no place have been sought for the second. And so I gave an example of your marriage as a covenant. Man can make a covenant with evil spirit also. And that is where we are going to be laying more of our emphasis, and we're going to be praying. The problem why we are dealing with covenant throughout this week, or one of the major reasons why we are dealing with covenant throughout this week, is that man has decided to enter into covenant with evil spirits. And sometimes, when people enter into covenant, they even boast about it. I was in Ghana recently, and there was one of these land guards or people who protect the lands and other things. And this guy could boast that when you shoot him, he will not die. When you do ABC to him, he will not die. He was boasting in the covenant that he had entered with an evil spirit. And so people boast of even the covenant that they have entered with evil spirit, simply because they've entered into covenant with evil spirit. Some even enter into covenant with death. That is why when you read Isaiah chapter 28 verse 18, there was a man who entered into covenant with death. and your covenant with death shall be dismantled, and your agreement with hell shall not stand. And so people enter into covenant. You understand what I'm saying? People enter into covenant with death, with evil spirit. There are evil men who enter into covenant. I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, you'll be shocked. There are people who sell their soul to the devil just to enter into covenant with the devil. And you see, many times, when people are entering into covenant, they don't think about the future generation. They only think about the now and the benefit they are going to get from the covenant without considering the consequences of their actions. And so people enter into covenant with deities and powers and evil spirit, and they put their children, their grandchildren in jeopardy. I remember years ago I wrote about a book called The Dust of Yesterday. I still have that book, where a man entered into covenant with an evil spirit just because he wanted power. He wanted to become the most powerful in the village. He wanted to become the most powerful. And so there are people who enter into covenant with evil spirit just because of political power, just because of a promotion in the office, just because they want to be an ambassador, they want to be a director, they want to head a department, they want to be promoted, they want to be lifted, they want to be great. And so they enter into strange covenants for protection, strange covenants for uplifting, so that they will be lifted. But you see, one thing I want to tell you is that Satan does not give anything for free. There are many of you who are watching me at the sound of my voice who are going through challenges. You are going through poverty. You are going through life battles, not because you did anything wrong, but because somebody entered into covenant on your behalf. Somebody entered into an evil covenant on your behalf, and that covenant is speaking in your life. That covenant is tormenting you. There are many of us, our fathers have established covenant, and the teeth of the children are set on edge because somebody entered into covenant on your behalf. There are families who have entered into covenant, and so the destiny of many of the young people who are even unborn, the destiny of the unborn generation, were sold on the altar of covenants. Ladies and gentlemen, that is why I want you to be very serious in this week as we deal with covenant, because any covenant that has not been broken will fight you on a higher plane. Any covenant that has been entered into, child of God, and you don't break it, that covenant has a propensity to speak. That covenant has the legal right to speak. Because in the spirit realm, we talk about legalities. Anything that has right over you has rule over you. And so you must rise up to break every covenant that is speaking in your family, covenant that is speaking in your life, covenant that is speaking that are contrary to your destiny. I've known people who have great destinies, but because somebody entered into covenant on their behalf. I say this all the time, that the children of Israel, Abraham entered into covenant on their behalf. Abraham already determined their destiny. The day God opened up Abraham and Abraham fell into coma, that was the day Abraham entered into covenant with God. And the destiny of the children of Israel were determined by Abraham, their father. And so I want to ask you, child of God, who is watching me and you are listening to me, who has determined your destiny by the covenant they have entered on your behalf? There are some of you, you come from royal backgrounds, and your destiny was even programmed even before you were born. Covenants were entered with strange gods and strange idols on your behalf even before your mother conceived you. Your destiny was already programmed by somebody entering into covenant on your behalf. Some of us, our grandparents entered into covenant on our behalf. Some of us, our fathers entered into strange covenants on our behalf, all in the name of protection, all in the name of keeping legacy. They enter into covenant. I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, I know that is why in some families, you will see some things happening, you will not understand why those things are happening. You see some families, there's so much abject poverty. You see so much abject poverty in the family. You see so much death in the family. People are dying mysteriously in the family, you will not understand. You see people go to university without a job. They stay at home for years without a job. You see young men who are useless becoming drunkards, who drink their life away, waste their life away. You see beautiful women. Nobody is asking the beautiful women, they are pretty, but nobody asks them, are you for sale? Are you for hire? Are you for rent? And yet they are pretty. When you start seeing such signs, and you see strange death, you see strange sicknesses in the family, which is hereditary, then you need to start asking yourself questions. Who has entered into a strange covenant on our behalf? I know a man who entered into a strange covenant to be rich. He became very wealthy. But after him, nobody became rich. Everybody started wandering in abject poverty because he entered into a covenant to be rich without considering the future generation. And so, I want to ask you a very simple question. Who has entered into covenant on your behalf? Even before you were born, who has entered into covenant on your behalf? There are many people who have entered into strange covenants by sleeping with strange women. I tell people all the time that sex is not just sex, sex is covenant. Anybody that you have sex with, you've entered into a spiritual covenant with a person. And there are many of us who have entered into spiritual covenant by sleeping with a strange man or a strange woman. I'm telling you, many have entered into covenant with witches and wizards. Many have entered into covenant with strange gods. And so it is time for us to pray so that we can break every covenant that is speaking in our lives. The covenant that are speaking in our lives, it is time for us to break those covenants. Any covenant your father has entered, any covenant your mother has entered, it is time for you and I to break that covenant. That covenant is still speaking, and it's time for you to break the covenant. Because so long as the covenant is speaking, the covenant will destroy things in your life. And so we need to pray, child of God, to deal with every covenant that is speaking in your life, every covenant that is speaking in your destiny, that is causing things not to go the way it ought to go in your life. When you are close to a miracle, you are close to a breakthrough, then something will go wrong. A covenant has been broken. A covenant. And you see, I'm going to say something very derogatory here. There are some of you come from backgrounds where your fathers have entered into covenant and you have not broken that covenant. And so long as you have not broken that covenant will speak in your life. It doesn't matter whether you are a believer. You can be tongue-speaking, child of God, Bible-believing. But if you don't break the covenant your fathers have entered into, or you don't break every old covenant, new ones cannot be established. You break the old covenant and establish a new covenant. And so you have to break the old covenant. Any covenant in your background, whether from your mother's side, your father's side, your husband's side, your wife's side, that is speaking against you, you need to pray and break the covenant. You have to break and break every covenant that is speaking in your life. Because a covenant which is evil places you under bondage. A covenant which is evil places you under bondage. And so there are many people that the devil has kept under bondage as a result of evil covenants that have been entered on their behalf. Today we are going to pray that every covenant which is evil that has been entered on your behalf, today we command the fire of God, we command the anointing of God to break every covenant that is speaking in your life in the precious name of Jesus Christ. I'm telling you, ladies and gentlemen, every covenant that is speaking in your life, because many of you have become born again, so the old shrine, maybe you don't attend to it again, you don't pour libation as your fathers, but have you broken the covenant that your fathers may have entered into, the legal right that your fathers may have given to the altar to speak? You have to break it. You have to break all the old covenant, break all the covenant you had with your exes, your ex-girlfriend, your ex-boyfriend. You have to break all this covenant. That covenant that was established through sex must be broken. Until the covenant is broken, you will still be in perpetual bondage. And so you have to pray. I know of a story of a lady who never spoke in Zima. She was not an Zima. We were taking her through deliverance, and the demon started speaking in Zima because her former boyfriend was an Zima. And the demon had entered into her through sex. And so there are many of you who will never be happy in your marriage if those covenants I'm talking about is not broken. If the covenant I'm talking about is not broken, ladies and gentlemen, forget it, you may never be happy. If your covenant with your exes and those who have had sex with you beside your husband is not broken, you can never be happy in your marriage. And so the covenant needs to be broken. The covenant needs to be broken. And many of us, we are walking and we are suffering because we are breaking the covenant of God. When the children of Israel broke the covenant of God, they suffered even more. Men were sleeping, women were having sex, and God got angry and brought his wrath upon Sodom and Gomorrah. And in our time today, we are experiencing the same Sodom and Gomorrah, where now LGBTQ laws are being enforced on people to become gays, to become lesbians. Hostility and all that is going on in our world today, more than even Sodom and Gomorrah. And so I am not surprised when we are talking about coronavirus and other things. And we who are children of God must pray. We must pray. And so I'm going to be leading you into some time of prayer. Tomorrow I'll talk about curses and other things by God's grace. So I want us to pray. Thank you, Holy Spirit. I want us to pray. La tone masita. La tone bereto sebratus kabalate. Today I just wanted to introduce the subject. Le barata masuli antayaba. Open your mouth and begin to pray the Lord. Thank the Lord for the word that has come. Open your mouth and thank him.
We thank you, your word has come for us.
Thank you for the word of the Lord.
Thank you, your word has come for us.
Father,
thank you.
Father,
we thank you, your word has come for us.
In the precious name of Jesus.
Jesus, we thank
you. Now we are taking our first prayer and we are saying, Lord, I disassociate myself and my family from every territorial blood covenant. Every blood covenant in my village, in my background, today, with my family, I disassociate myself from every covenant that is speaking in my life. In the name of Jesus, every blood covenant that is speaking in my family, every blood covenant that is speaking in the life of my children, every blood covenant that is speaking in the church, today as I pray in the name of Jesus, let that covenant be broken. Open your mouth, begin to pray. Father, we break every blood covenant that is speaking in the name of Jesus. Every blood covenant, oh God, we cancel by the authority in the blood of Jesus. Masanda kamado shabaliata. Lift your voice, somebody begin to pray against every evil covenant. Every covenant that is speaking in your life. Every covenant that is speaking in the life of your children. Every covenant that is speaking in your destiny. We command the covenant to break in the name of Jesus. Let the covenant be broken right now. Let the covenant be broken in the name of Jesus. We curse every covenant, oh God. We curse every covenant, oh God. Every blood covenant, oh God. Let the covenant be broken by fire, by thunder. Let the covenant be broken in the name of Jesus. Let the covenant be broken in the name of Jesus. Let the covenant be broken in the name of Jesus. Father, we break the covenant. Father, we destroy the covenant. Let the covenant be broken. Let the covenant be destroyed. In the name of Jesus Christ, we command the covenant to be broken. We command the covenant to be destroyed. In the name of Jesus Christ, let the covenant be broken. Let the covenant be broken. Let the covenant be broken. We command the covenant. Let the covenant be broken in our going and coming, of God. Let the covenant be broken. Let the covenant be broken. Let the covenant be broken. Every covenant of God that is speaking in my life, every covenant of God that is speaking in my family, every covenant of God, territorial blood covenant, today I plead the blood of Jesus to destroy every territorial blood covenant speaking in my life by the authority in the name of Jesus. Let the covenant be broken. Child of God, lift your voice. Begin to break that covenant. Covenant speaking in my background, every evil covenant speaking in my family, every evil covenant speaking in my destiny, every evil covenant speaking in my glory. Let the covenant be broken, let the covenant be destroyed in the precious name of Jesus. Today I break the covenant, today I destroy the covenant by the audacity of Jesus, by the authority of Jesus. Iman tolere no se, apadini akate, prekete masie, apani antos kapanie. Let the power of the Holy Ghost, by the power of the Holy Ghost, let the altar be destroyed. Let every altar of covenant that is breaking in my life, let it be broken in Jesus' name.
I break the covenant in the name of Jesus.
We also pray that every tribal blood covenant, every tribal blood covenant, today we break it in the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus.
Every tribal blood covenant, let it be broken.
Yes.
Every tribal blood covenant be broken in the name of Jesus.
Name of Jesus.
We dismantle every blood covenant. In the name of Jesus. We dismantle every blood covenant. Every blood covenant that is speaking in my life. Every blood covenant, tribal blood covenant, emanating from my background, my village, my tribe. In the name of Jesus, I command it to be broken. In the name that is above every other name, every tribal covenant speaking in my life, speaking in my family, speaking in the life of my children, let the covenant be broken in Jesus' name. Let the covenant be broken in Jesus' name. Let the covenant be broken in Jesus' name. I command the covenant to break. I command the covenant to be destroyed. I command the covenant to break in the name of Jesus. Let the covenant be broken. 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 Every covenant of God that is emanating from my background in the name of Jesus, oh God, I break the covenant. I break the covenant. I break the covenant in the name of Jesus. I pray the covenant of God, the covenant with evil, the covenant with idols, the covenant with deities. I pray the covenant of God, let the covenant be broken, let the covenant be destroyed. I pray in the name of Jesus, every covenant that is speaking in my life, covenant speaking in my background, covenant speaking in the life of my children, let the covenant be broken now, let the covenant be destroyed now, in the name of Jesus. I pray that covenant now, I pray that covenant now, I pray that covenant now. He upon me a pedibatoria, upon me a pediatai, upon me a cape, upon a matose, upon me a caparia, upon the Lord of Sandra, Every animal Jesus. We know our prayers have been answered because we pray in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus Christ. Now, stretch your hands as I pray for you. Lord, King of Kings, Lord of Lords, Everlasting Father, we thank you for the privilege to be a blessing once again. We thank you for this week. We thank you for ordering our steps this week. As we go out, we ask for your covering, your protection. We ask that, Lord, every covenant that is speaking our destiny, every covenant that is speaking our lives, Father, let it be broken in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Every contention of our lives, let it be broken in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let the works of darkness over our families be destroyed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Every conscious covenant, unconscious covenant, that are speaking in our destiny, today we break it in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We break of their mother's house, of their father's house, today we break it in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
And we command their liberty in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Be free